Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Morning Brew pre-show. Just getting set up here in the studio. A little bit of a late start today. I spent the morning at the auto shop getting that state inspection done. It was only a month and a half overdue. Hey, Google, what's the weather today in Washington, D.C.?
In Washington today, it'll be sunny with a forecasted high of 75 and a low of 53. Right now, it's 65 and sunny.
Wow, beautiful weather. Gorgeous, gorgeous weather. Hey, Google, what's the weather in Seattle?
In Seattle today, it'll be partly cloudy with a forecasted high of 62 and a low of 45. Right now, it's 50 and cloudy.
Oh my. It is Monday, October 2nd, and the time right now is 10:34 a.m. here on the East Coast of the United States. Wolves, good morning. Abel, good morning. Hello, everybody. Let me jump into the studio and harass everybody. Good morning, guys and gal.
Gino's back.
I'm here at the studio this morning with Falandir, Jonas, and Magic. Good morning, everybody.
On Donut Monday.
It is Donut Monday. Man, we got a donut story that'll light you up.
Literally.
So the first test of for everybody who had gold access and above in Dual Universe happened on Saturday, and it was my hats off to the guys, the team over there at Nova Quark. They worked their butts off. I hope their boss kept them well fed. We're grateful for their hard work.
So, what was your opinion?
Oh, my opinion? Oh, it's too early to give any kind of opinion. It's okay. It's just, you know, full of lots of hard work ahead. Lots of hard work. One K. Good morning, man. Ashlyn, hey, traveler, greeting. And before we get too far into the show this morning, just our hearts and prayers go out to everybody who's been touched by the tragedy in Las Vegas. It's all over the news. We don't need to discuss it, but wow, it's dreadful. We'll talk about it more maybe later this week after more details come in. At this point, everything is speculation. Our game today is going to be Dark and Light. Can't wait to get back into this. I had fun last week. So much fun. Friday was a blast. We got to get more folks into the Overwatch mayhem.
Geo, I see you joined the server at 10:30.
Join what server?
Dark and Light.
Oh, I'm in, dude.
Yep.
My
panel tells me when people come in.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. All right. Wow. We should...
Are we ready?
We should push the pram a lot. Yeah, a little bit of a late start today, everybody. Apologies. Had to rush to the auto shop this morning to get my state inspection done. It expired at the end of August. My buddy GP, who runs the shop, it's a Mercedes shop, he looked at me and said, "Shame on you, Mr. George."
I just found out after you said that only 17 states have inspections now.
Oh, yeah, we don't have it anymore.
You're kidding.
No, that's it. Florida got rid of it years ago, so did South Carolina.
Oh, that's terrifying. Oh, goodness. All right, Phil, shall we push the pram a lot?
Let us proceed.
Let's push the pram a lot. And live from Studio G, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Morning Brew Show. We are here. Man, glad to be here. Glad to be here. We're going to be doing some Dark and Light today. Some Dark and Light mischief. Make sure you're following us on our social media. And you can watch us live on Twitter as well. We're periscoping, as we do with every broadcast. We got some cool tech news to cover this morning. And The mystery of the glowing donuts has been solved. We will share with you the magic. The magic that only Falander could bring us. It's so nice to see everybody. Hope you had a great weekend. Beautiful weather out there. Wow. Man. I'm looking forward to doing some gaming. Covering some tech news. We got a cool news feed this morning, Fal. Man, so much stuff. It just there's more news. There's more news in a 24-hour cycle than we can cover, let alone what happens over the weekend. Wow. So lead us off. You know what? Before we get
really
started, though,
stop doing that, man.
Stop doing that.
Yeah, that.
Why?
Because you do it constantly. It's getting to be really aggravating.
Woo! If only you were here so I could tweak you on the nose.
Right?
All right. Before I get started, though, man, that joke from Harrison Ford is stuck in my head. I was going to tell it to the gal at the drive-thru. I was going to tell it to the gal at the drive-thru this morning because, you know, I give her a joke a day every time I go through, and I figured she hadn't heard that one yet. And I get to the drive-thru. I mean, I get to McDonald's, and I realize, you know what? I want to get a sandwich, too. I'm going to just go in and talk to everybody. So I didn't get to see her. But in sad McDonald's-related news, they raised the price of their coffee by 38 cents. I kid you not, 38 cents overnight. Saturday, the price was normal. Today, 38 cents. Who does that? What the heck? What the heck are they thinking?
Coffee was 38 cents or raised by 30?
They raised the price of my coffee by 38 cents.
That's weird.
It's 38% increase in the price of coffee.
So it went from $1 to $1.38?
It went from $1. Yeah, it went from $1 to $1.38. I'm listening to myself on Twitch. I mean, Twitter.
Probably wouldn't have noticed this, but did they raise the price of the senior coffee?
Bucktooth Granny, what's happening, brother? Welcome back, man. Oh, my God. One of the greatest names in Twitch. In Twitch history. Welcome back to the show, man. Good to see you. Yeah, they raised the price of my coffee. But luckily, you know, you get the free refill thing. So I'm going to take this back to McDonald's after the show and get them to refill it. Yeah, but you've been away for 4 hours. Too bad. But it's still, you know, even at $1.38, Jonas, it's still a bargain. You can't get coffee that delicious for that price anywhere else but McDonald's. So,
I'm not a particularly huge fan of their coffee. It's a little bit too bold for me, shall we say?
Oh, well, then you're not a Starbucks guy either.
No, I like Starbucks because their breakfast blend is pretty mellow.
Typhoon, and you paid it, didn't you? Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Now, dude, the Starbucks, I just get the regular coffee, and, man, it's like rocket fuel. The caffeine is...
Right? Yeah, their regular coffee is pretty crazy.
Yeah.
I, you know, stopped drinking coffee at my doctor's advice, and I still have some Starbucks breakfast blend, and every single time I'll drink, like, a half a cup of that stuff, and my eyes are just like ants crawling.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Well... It's still the cheapest game in town. So, Fal, what do we got there for the first story, huh? First story of the day.
Donuts.
Donuts. Oh, seriously. Oh, right, man. This comes to us from, from Falander and Mashable. This is when... Oh, here we go. Man, when I saw this, I thought it was a joke. I thought for sure this cannot be real.
Oh, cool.
But the glowing donut. Look at this. Look at that. In Sydney, Australia. You got to go to Sydney, Australia to get these damn things.
And I immediately think about the whole processing and the other end part.
And you ask yourself, what the hell's in these things? They're gonna show us. I like the music. It's cool. It's got vitamins. Get your vitamins. I get my vitamins from Guinness, yet mine doesn't glow in the dark. I don't know what's up with that, but...
These don't either. If you'll notice, they have a black light on it.
Dude, that's all the reason to turn my black light. Dig it out of the closet and turn it on. That's awesome. Donuts and coffee. It's why we exist. Donuts, coffee, and well, gaming. Oh, if you love Coca-Cola and coffee, then check this out, everybody. Good news. There's now a Coca-Cola coffee. Coca-Cola's Coffee Plus. Their limited edition caffeinated beverage. No sugar. Ah, great. I like it. I don't like sugar in my coffee. We all tried this coffee drink. As weird as it sounds, it's actually good. I like the video. What? It's where's this? Korea? It's in
Japan.
Japan. Oh, even more confusing. All right. What do we got next, Val?
Okay, now we go back in time.
And now I want donuts. Darn it.
To the era of Danish King Harald Bluetooth.
Danish King Harald Bluetooth. Oh my goodness. This is the Viking fort that we mentioned on Friday's show?
Yep.
Unbelievable. So let's get into the story. Viking fort reveals secrets of Danish king's elaborate military network. Interesting. So is it elaborate military network? What pray tell would that be?
A major fort complex.
Bluetooth?
Actually, I think what they're referring to is he had forts everywhere.
The discovery of the Viking Age fortress in Denmark has shed new light on a network of military sites built by the 10th century Danish king Harald Bluetooth, according to archaeologists. Bluetooth, for whom the eponymous digital network technology is named. Uh-huh. Is credited with building several large circular fortresses or ringed forts. This is amazing that they're digging this stuff up now, or we're just maybe they've been doing this for years and we're just now hearing about it. I don't know, but built in 970s and 980s. Good God Almighty! As unified the unruly Viking clans of the region into a centralized kingdom. Oh, so this sounds like season 8 of Vikings, right? And we got a video here. What the hell is the video about? Is it related at all? There's, I don't know.
No, this, I think we've already looked at this.
All right. Until a few years ago, the sites of four such ringed forts were known, and in the decades since they were found, debates have ranged among Danish historians about these structures' purpose. See more photos of the Viking Age fortresses. Let's do that. And if there's a video, let me know, please. Well, that's not a photo. it's a rendering. What, man, I tell you, the junk, the web has just become unusable. Al Gore's amazing internet has been taken over by spam. Jonas, we were talking about this. Kidding. Dude, it's just dreadful.
It really is. And it's getting worse.
It is. Because
they're starting to push TV through the internet.
Oh yeah,
like for everything.
So when I go to my Twitter homepage, there's a live TV feed in there, and it's like, oh, I just don't need that. Don't need that extra. It's just crazy. Though I do have the bandwidth to handle it. In fact, let's on a different note, let's take a look at my bandwidth today. What do we have? You guys ready? You ready for this? Little bandwidth check. Here we go. Check the Verizons. Download speed, Okay, not too shabby. At 270, 280, 290, 300. Oh, broke 300. Maybe, maybe not, maybe. Yay, 308. And the upload. The upload's phenomenal. Look at this. Breaks 400, 420, 430. 440. Oh, here, 450. Got 450. Going once, going twice. Yes! We get, broke 450. Using that bandwidth here, it's crazy. All right. More pictures of the ring forts. This is neat. Enlarge. The enlarge button doesn't really do what I was hoping. There we go. Well, that is neat. The excavations. Boy, they're going to be... this is take a while, that kind of archaeological research. Well, they're going to find a lot of stuff here. I think we're going to... they've probably already found it. We won't start to see it for a little while. Yeah, Beowulfs. So it's funny. If I connect wirelessly to my Verizon Fios router, they throttle my data. They throttle it. They throttle the throughput. But if I connect I'm connecting wirelessly to my main wireless hub in the house, and that's connected with a hardwire to the Fios router, and there's no data throttling that way. Interesting stuff, man. Has anybody ever gone to an archaeological dig or worked on an archaeological project?
I can't say. Well, I haven't worked on one, but I have been to Olympia in Greece.
Ooh. Nice.
And of course, the Parthenon.
Oh, that's cool stuff, man.
Be right back.
Yep. I think the only one I've ever been to is Jamestown, which was interesting, intriguing. They had, stuff with the university going on there. So, all right, what do we got next there, Fal?
16 successful landings for Falcon 9 boosters.
we got two. Do we have two videos for this or just one?
Just one for that one.
All right. Well, kudos to Elon and SpaceX. This is just extraordinary. It is literally rocket science. I mean, look at this. The beat goes on. It is amazing, literally amazing what he's accomplished. And now that we see what he's planning for the future for travel, Earth to Earth, it's all making a lot more sense now.
That is so cool.
Some great shots too. And I mean, he's landing this thing on the dime. I mean, it's amazing. Just amazing. You know how much that thing weighs? I mean, it's huge. I don't know if you guys have had a chance to see this thing up close. It is ginormous.
Yeah, but it's not as big as the Saturn V.
Yeah, boy, the Saturn V is really something. So... I don't know, for the space plane that he's working on, it doesn't use this rocket, does it? It's going to require a larger one.
I understand it reuses the same principle.
Yeah, so same tech, the same brain can go in their stuff, but that is just extraordinary stuff, man. Just amazing. Way to go, Elon Musk. You are changing the face of technology and space and culture. He's an amazing dude. And yes, I have a man crush on him. Oh, check this out. I like this one. This might also be in the feed. So this is the project on Mars. So this is how he sees the expansion. So let's see what they got here. I dig this expansion. It's a great concept. There he's got the landing pads, and then you've got your little village, and then he sees it growing like this. I don't know. You got to find a way to be able to protect that stuff from crap falling, hitting the planet. I don't know. That's going to be the biggest challenge of all, and on the moon as well. So don't know how they're going to crack that nut. It's, frankly, I'm surprised there hasn't been any disaster at the space station all these years. All right, Fal, what's next in the news feed there?
Let's jump down three articles to an article from Life Science where there's actually a video of Elon Musk talking about his Mars ship.
About his the robotic thing at Life Science? Oh, here we go.
No.
I see it. It's the one after that. All right. Elon Musk wants giant SpaceX spaceship to fly people to Mars by 2024. Whoa. Way to go, Elon.
I know, right? Like, this is 5 years from now he's talking about. Like, he's going to have shuttles to Mars in 5 years is his goal. That's insane.
Yeah. It really... Make sure what?
Of potatoes.
And poop. Right. Poopies. Gotta have poopies.
And lots of poop. God. See, we really need to make a Mars version of Conan with poop.
So, guys, just for the record, you know, this dude's got a billionaire buddy in Australia, and they are making bets that only billionaires could make. And we've got an article about that in the news feed this morning, I think. I love it that these guys are challenging each other. I don't know what kind of relationship he's got with Jeff Bezos. I hope it's positive. We'll see. Anyway, check this out.
Becoming a multi-planet species. Beats the hell out of being a single-planet species. So, so we'd start off by sending a mission to Mars, where it would be obviously just landing on rocky ground or dusty ground. And it's the same approach that I mentioned before, which is you send the spaceship up to orbit, you re-tank it or refill it until it has full tanks, it travels to Mars, lands on Mars. For Mars, you will need local propellant production. But Mars has a CO2 atmosphere and plenty of water ice. That gives you CO2 and H2O. So you can make, therefore, CH4 and O2. Using the Sabatier process, probably Sabatier process, and I should mention that long term, this can also be done on Earth. So sometimes I get some sort of criticism for why are you using combustion.
He's a terrible public speaker, but that doesn't bother him. Doesn't bother me either, but it's just. But he's a very smart dude. It's just frightening what goes on inside this guy's brain. A day in there would just scare the hell out of me.
I actually have to put quite a bit of effort into learning how to be a good public speaker.
Actually, he's better at it when he's on one of his pogroms.
That's true.
In rockets, and you have electric cars. You're like, well, there isn't some way to make an electric rocket. I wish there was.
An electric rocket.
In the long term, you can use solar power to extract CO2 from the atmosphere, combine it with water, and produce fuel and oxygen for the rocket. So the same thing that we would do on Mars, we could do on Earth in the long term. But that's essentially what happens. Similar to the moon, you land on Mars. But the tricky thing with Mars is we do need to build a propellant depot to refill the tanks and return to Earth. But because Mars has a lower gravity than Earth, you do not need a booster. So you can go all the way from the surface of Mars to the surface of Earth just using the ship. Albeit you need to go to a max payload number of about 20 to 50 tons.
I gotta pause again. This guy taught himself rocket science. He literally taught himself rocket science. Just let that soak in for a moment. He had this vision from the time he was a kid going to Mars, and he had visions for all these things. PayPal, I think, was just an opportunity, just kind of a fluke. He saw a problem and wanted to solve it. And boy, parlayed that into what funded his next big thing, which was Tesla. And Tesla was about to fold, and he took the last of his profits from PayPal and sunk it into Tesla. Told everybody else to shove off at Tesla. Who, you know, the people that had lost faith or whatever, that, you know, and they parted ways, took full ownership control of Tesla, saved the company with just sheer willpower and determination. Bloody proud of that guy.
Interestingly, this isn't actually too far of a story from what happened with Valve.
Yeah,
the first 18 months of Valve Software's life, you know, building Half-Life, they got to the end of it and just decided, hey, we don't want to release this. And so Gabe just paid out of pocket for the next 18 months of development.
And you were working there at the time, correct?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
that's amazing. Well, so he saved Tesla, saved his dream for that part. But that was just one aspect of his larger vision. I mean, his burning desire the whole time, what's driving this guy is he wants to get to Mars.
Yeah, and he wants to do it right. That's the other thing. That's kind of why I was mentioning about Half-Life and Valve.
Yeah.
Because you know, doing it the right way.
And he realized that there's so many things that hadn't been invented yet, and that he was probably going to have to invent these. So he teaches. I let this sink in. He teaches himself rocket science. I'm not joking about this. He teaches himself rocket science, and becomes an expert. And next thing we see is, well, we showed it earlier. 16 successful landings. And what was really funny is he's very self-effacing. He put all of his failures on public display, made a funny video about him just to, you know, kind of mock himself a little bit. So he's a good-natured guy, great attitude, gutsy, self-made man. But on the other half of that is, so we got SpaceX working, and now he's sucking at the taxpayer teat, as it were. So a lot of his greatness is now coming from the U.S. taxpayer, but that's okay. I'm okay with that. It's good.
Gio, remember this? I forget who said it, and I'm probably paraphrasing, but some great inventor said that we learn more from failure than from success.
Oh, it's true. Was that Da Vinci? I don't know.
I don't remember.
Stage, single stage.
All right, check out the rest of this.
And I'll show you so this is the true physics simulation. This will last about a minute. So you come in, you're entering very quickly, going 7.5 kilometers a second. For Mars, there will be some ablation of the heat shield. So it's just like a sort of brake pad wearing away. It is a multi-use heat shield. But unlike for Earth operations, it's coming in hot enough that you will see some wear of the heat shield. But because Mars has an atmosphere, albeit not a particularly dense one, you can remove almost all the energy aerodynamically. And we've proven out supersonic retropropulsion many times with Falcon 9, so we feel very comfortable about that. You can see sort of a mesh system. It's not meant to be sort of particularly pretty because it's just trying to simulate the physics of it. But the size of the cone gives you a rough approximation for how much thrust.
I think I got it.
you just gotta love what this guy's doing. What a strong vision. I mean, he's really literally solving every problem in the entire loop to make it a reality.
That's not a typo.
2022 cargo missions.
Although it is aspirational.
Like, you remember that movie, The Martian?
We've already
where they had a ship that was just looping between the two planets repeatedly? That's basically what he's building.
We're there. 2022.
The touring, for the main tanks has been ordered. The facility is being built. We will start construction of the first ship. around the second quarter of next year, so in about 6 to 9 months.
So
we should start building the first ship.
So I know he wants desperately to go to Mars, but I beg, I implore him, don't do that yet. All right. Send these young, super physically fit astronauts and scientists and you know, engineers and security. Send those guys first. Let them do the heavy lifting, because God forbid something happened to this guy. You know, whoops. He jettisons himself out of an airlock accidentally, which I don't think would happen, but he ate the spicy potato and exploded. Anyway, I continue.
I feel fairly confident that we can complete the ship and be ready for a launch in about 5 years. 5 years seems like a long time to me. Yeah.
5 years. Guy is amazing.
And the area under the curve of resources over that period of time should enable this time frame to be met. But if not this time frame, I think pretty soon thereafter. But that's our goal, is to try to make the 2022 Mars rendezvous. The Earth-Mars synchronization happens roughly every 2 years. So every 2 years, there's an opportunity for...
Every 2 years. All right.
To fly to Mars. So then in 2024, we want to try to fly 4 ships, two of which would be crewed, and two cargo and two crew. The goal of these initial missions is to find the best source of water. That's for the first mission. And then the second mission, the goal is to build the propellant.
So
we should, particularly with 6 ships, there have plenty of landed mass to construct the propellant depot, which will consist of a large array of solar panels.
Sasha Gishiri, welcome to the show. Thanks for the follow.
Everything necessary to mine and refine water. And
so every 2 years, you have the window to launch to Mars. Ambitious. So it gives them time to do a lot of planning. But finding a source of water on Mars is the big challenge. And of course, what makes the most sense is the poles. They have no idea what the weather's like there, huh? Can you guys imagine? I love this next picture here. Check
Can't
this
be
out.
Worse than last weekend in Seattle.
So check the, look at this. This, I mean, it looks, that looks real. Isn't that funny? This is what he envisions, though. And we showed the video on his, on SpaceX Twitter feed earlier that shows basically this thing from the top down and how they expect it to evolve. But that he realizes he needs to be able to refuel these things on Mars, and is already planning how to do that is pretty extraordinary. Mew Mew, how are you? Good morning, and hello everybody. Welcome to the show. That is just extraordinary. Fal, there's a little more on his talk. Do we need to show the rest of it? The end of it? Have you watched it?
Yeah, it does. It doesn't say much more.
Okay. Man, and then we have another one here. This comes from CNET. Pictures on Mars, Mars human landing, NASA, Elon Musk.
Yep. It just adds some pictures and adds that both NASA and Mars One are also working on getting to Mars in the next 15 years.
Boy, so I gotta close some of these. There we go.
Oh, yeah, this is the one I dropped in.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
And I had a comment on this that's only partly related to the article itself. Why do they call things like this a roadmap when there's no actual map or timeline shown? Just kind of irks me. Anyway.
It's called bait and switch, David.
Anyway. interesting pictures. Most of these we've seen. Oh, this is cool. So this little rocket right here intrigues me a great deal. If that's the one I'm thinking of, we showed that rocket Friday. It has that new propulsion system. Man, I'm telling you, get that guy teamed up with Elon, that would be extraordinary. Looks like a great technology.
So is that really only 9 meters wide?
Yep, only 9 meters.
Wow,
wide.
That is not a lot of space.
It's like an airliner.
If you look at a football field, that's roughly the same width as from one solid line to the next one. Mm-hmm. That's it.
Yeah,
that's one down right there.
Yep,
everything has to fit within that space.
Pretty cool stuff. All right, what do we got next there, Fal?
Robot farmers.
Robot farmers. This is very appealing to me. I think what a great thing to have robots do. Farming. Anybody here spent time on a farm ever?
Me, most of my life before I joined the Navy.
I spent several summers on my uncle's soybean farm, and I had to work at age 6 and 7 and 8. I had to work. It was those were really hot, rough summers. But it was fun. It was fun, and all the kids that I was working with were all like 10 years older. So I learned all the bad words early. It was a seed group. This is in Arkansas, but boy, it's bloody hard work, and a lot of the work. If you add a little bit of AI, a little bit of tech, some robotics, man, you could simplify things dramatically, and really make farming something that, becomes a high tech profession. Just saying, get to spend a little bit of time outdoors. Nothing like getting a little dirty, though. Dirty's good. So this hands-free hectare is an experimental farm run by researchers from Harper Adams University in the United Kingdom. Let me show up. That's intriguing. I wonder what they're growing.
Spring barley.
Spring barley. Okay, I was going to say it looks like bluegrass, but... at the hands-free hectare... An experimental farm run by researchers from Harper Adams University in the village of Edgemond in the UK. About 5 tons of spring barley have been harvested from the world's first robotic tended farm. Everything from start to finish, including sowing, fertilizing, collecting samples, and harvesting, has been done by autonomous vehicles on the farm, according to the researchers. The team behind the project thinks that robotic technology could improve yields in agriculture, which is necessary if the world's growing population is to be fed in coming years. So one other advantage of this is you can do farming in parts of the world where there may not be the manpower or knowledge to do it successfully and to get high yields. So I my greatest hope would be that this would make farming more accessible and more productive in many parts of the world.
I think of two things. I think of the movie Interstellar, where they had the robotic combines running around everywhere.
Oh yeah, that's right.
And then I think of my cousin, who is a farmer, and the thing he loves to do more than anything else is just. Doing rows in his combine all day. And, well, we're going to take that away from him.
Yeah, indeed.
Now the farmers, who are the only ones who keep trying to get away from the offices by getting out into the fields, are going to be stuck in offices watching their machines do the fields.
Check this out. The researchers purchased several small-sized agricultural machines, including a tractor, a combine, a machine for harvesting grain crops, and then they fitted the machines with actuators, electronics, and robot technology that would allow them to control the machines without the presence of a human operator. Oh, my God. That is something. Is there any video of the harvesting actually being done?
I haven't found any yet.
That's a fail. Come on. These guys, they got to do that. They got to learn how to promote. Because the best they got is this picture of a drone. Anyway, what do we got next there, Fal?
Strange science.
Okay, this is a little bizarre. Do we have a video?
A man in England who thought he had lung cancer received some good but strange news. Instead of a tumor, the man had a tiny toy traffic cone lodged in his airway. The cone was a part of a playset he had received and accidentally inhaled over 40 years ago as part of a birthday present. And over in the South Pacific, scientists have discovered a rare new species of rat. What makes the rodent unique? Well, they're four times...
freaking terrifying. Look at this beast. All right. The tree he's sitting on is a giant redwood. This rat is 400 feet long. I'm just kidding. Check it out though.
Bigger than the rats you'll find here. From nose to tail, they can measure up to 18 inches long and weigh in at more than 2 pounds.
2 pounds!
And down in Mexico, doctors are warning travelers to avoid drinking 7-Up. The reason? There have been reports of meth-laced bottles of the soft drink. Health officials in Mexico said that the drug-laced sodas killed one person and sickened 7 others. And that's this week's Strange News Snapshot. I'm Sarah Miller of Life Science.
Thank you, Sarah.
She's utterly pleasant. Can somebody teach her the subtle science of transitioning? Because she just went from one story to another without taking a break.
Well, you know, when time is of the essence. So Fal was telling me this morning about the 7-Up bottles. Dreadful.
How do you?
Excuse me. Sneezy. They make me sneeze.
Oh. How do you accidentally inhale a traffic cone?
Yeah, he was a kid. He was a kid. It was 40 years ago. And the little traffic cone just lodged in his airway. I don't know. That's a suspicious story right there. Just saying. Headless toads in jar.
Anyway, Gio?
Yeah.
I've seen rats that big or bigger in Europe.
Dude, I've seen rats that big or bigger in New York City. Oh my God. You know?
We had one that actually knocked the rat guard off the line, and they're tied pretty tight.
Jeez. Alrighty. Well, life science, thank you for all of that. Oh, what do we got next there, Fal?
Largest battery installation is halfway done.
What a story. So this goes back to Elon. If you guys remember, we covered a story where he made a bet that if he couldn't install the world's largest battery installation, if he couldn't do it in 100 days, he'd do it for free. So turns out this bet was with a billionaire friend of his. So Tesla says world's largest battery installation is halfway done. But Tesla and South Australia are starting the countdown now. So that's interesting because, it seems like he got a head start there. Man, boy, the season is upon us. At Jamestown, South Australia event on Friday, Tesla CEO Elon Musk announced that the company was halfway done installing a 100-megawatt that utility grade battery bank near the site of the 100-megawatt Hornsdale wind farm. This is cool stuff. The battery bank will be the largest grid-tied system in the world when it's complete. Currently, the largest grid-tied system is the 30-megawatt one that's built by AES Energy in Southern California. The project grew out of a Twitter bet. A Twitter bet. Seriously. All right, this starts out of a Twitter bet. Come on. This is what's so cool. I bet I can get to Mars before you do. You know, neener, neener. Between Australian software billionaire Mike Cannon Brooks. What guys have hyphenated names? It's kind of weird. Just saying. And Tesla SpaceX CEO Elon Musk, in response to Cannon Brooks' incredulity about the speed that Tesla was claiming it could install grid-tied batteries. Musk promised to deliver a system to South Australia, a state that suffered debilitating blackouts in recent summers, and those have made the news. It's been staggering. In 100 days, install it in 100 days or it's free. But 100 days or it's free didn't include the time negotiating contracts and after the bet Tesla went through competitive bidding process. All the while, they're building the batteries as fast as they can because he was certain he was going to win this this bid. And they went through the competitive bidding process with the state of South Australia for access to $150 million, that's Australian dollars, $115 million U.S. renewable energy fund to cover the cost of the batteries. Wow. So it turns out the batteries only cost, what, 30 mil? Earlier this year, Musk gave estimates on Twitter that suggested the 129-megawatt system would cost about $32 million before taxes and labor. Tesla won the bidding round and partnered with French company Neoen, the owner of the Hornsdale Wind Farm in the mid-north region of Australia. Musk later commented that Tesla missed its 100-day, that if Tesla missed its 100-day deadline, the company could stand to lose $50 million or more. But he's a determined chap. He's not going to lose. He's very competitive. He's got such a nice demeanor. He's competitive in a nice way. I don't know. But he likes to play Overwatch. So wouldn't you like to be in an Overwatch match against Elon? Just saying. Mew Mew. Hey, man. Muren says, progressive guys who are willing to hyphenate with their wives when they get married. I don't know. I'm not that man. Just saying. But Tesla has apparently given itself a wide berth to make that 100-day deadline as the company has already been working on getting the Hornsdale installation up and running. He's a cheater. He cheats. Right? But we all benefit. So, as the company's already been working on getting the installation up, according to the Australian Broadcasting Corporation (ABC), Musk said on Friday night that Tesla was already about halfway done with building the battery bank and installing the batteries. The batteries are being made at the Tesla Panasonic Gigafactory in Sparks, Nevada, and we've covered that one as well. Isn't that the one that's the largest building in the world?
I think so.
ABC also noted that South Australian Premier Jay Weatherill was in attendance at Tesla's Friday night party. Who the hell is this guy? He told the crowd, there were lots of people there that were making jokes about South Australia and making fun of our leadership in renewable energy. Well, today they're laughing out the other side of their face. Musk told the crowd, to have that construction done in 2 months, you can't remodel your kitchen in that period of time. Yeah, amen, dude. And there's that celebration at Cassini. The Tesla CEO also seemed to make an opening bid for more Tesla projects in Australia. According to ABC, the CEO told, they got that, he wants to use up all that renewable energy fund. Yep. That's, I know how this guy thinks. Elon, he's always looking for the, you know, there's some public money. I can make some money from that and go do my Mars thing. Just saying. He's no slouch. The CEO told the Friday night crowd that Australia could be powered by 1,890 square kilometers of solar panels, roughly a tenth the area of Sydney, backed up by 7 square kilometers of batteries. Tesla's recent purchase of the solar panel manufacturer SolarCity, which is his Tesla. He always owned SolarCity. That was his thing. So he bought himself. Isn't that rich? Just saying. Could put the company in a position to offer solar fields as well. Go, Elon, go. You know, good on you, buddy. Wow. All right, what do we got next there, Fal?
Before we proceed, it's 11:28. Do you want to continue or to tomorrow?
Well, let's see. There, we got a couple things. Yeah, we got a patent that's holding up AI progress.
Yeah, we got four more articles in today.
Yep, and see, we got Ragnarok theory. Oh, that one's cool. Save that for tomorrow. And Stein plays from Diphidu. We'll save that for tomorrow too. And then,
no, that's just a picture. That takes 5 seconds, dude.
Really? How to tell if your laptop is warm in the back?
Look close.
I think I see it.
I think I already know without seeing it. I do have another way that a man could get a hyphenated name.
You know, you've got it cropped weird. That's why you can't see it. Zoom out.
There it is. Look at that. You see that? Mm-hmm. There's a cat. Bad Viking. What's up, man?
And just so you know, it's pronounced Dina.
Dina?
She.
Oh, Stina.
She's Norwegian.
Ah, great. She's cool. She's cool. She's fun. Well, we got a bunch of great news articles. We'll just save for tomorrow since we're running out of time. And we got a great one here from Jonas talking about games. So it's something we want to talk about in greater detail. There's a lot to discuss. And just to say that I think Jewel Universe had a wonderful Saturday event for everybody who was gold and above. Got in and got their feet wet. Got to see the inside of Jewel Universe.
I got my feet wet too.
Yeah, literally.
Yeah.
So it's under the Jewel Universe thing is under NDA. But what I can say is that those guys at NovaQuark worked their tails off, and kudos to them. That's just an epic effort, and I hope they garnered all the info and whatever feedback that they need to take it to the next step. I don't even know when the next test will be, but it was love that company. Those guys, a bunch of hardworking folks, and they got a great vision, so fingers crossed. All right, Fal. So we're gonna be doing some Dark and Light next. So if you've got the game, come join us. Oh my God, we had a great time at Dark and Light last week, and we continue today to make up for Friday's Overwatch. And for God's sake, if you've got Overwatch or if you don't have Overwatch, get it. It is a crazy fun game. As everybody here who can tell you who plays it is maybe Fal and I and Jonas and Murin and. Boy, everybody who joins us. And Jet, oh, he got so mad when I told him we played Overwatch on Friday. It's like, Dad, can I just stay home when you play that? And no, you're going to school. All right. We'll be right back. Thanks for watching the first part of the Morning Brew Show, folks. We got a little bit of a late start today because I had to take my car to the shop and then hit the bank. But we'll be live here shortly with Dark and Light. Come join us.
Have fun.
Thanks, man.
I should be getting, hopefully this next weekend I'll get that RAM.
Oh, awesome. Oh, great, great stuff, dude. Be right back, everybody. Disconnection, you're calling again. Fort Bed Bluff, thanks for the follow, man. Cheers and welcome to Twitch. Welcome to the show. All right, I'm back. Beady, beady, beady. Where'd Val go?
You said AFK.
All right. Nice to see everybody. Welcome to the Morning Brew Show. We're going to do some dark and light here. Ah, there we go. Got the music taken care of. Aha. What'd you call me? Murin? You said I'm a cute fairy? It's the sweetest thing you've ever said to me. All right. So who's in, Magic?
I'm in. You're in.
Sorry, my computer shut down for an unknown reason.
Oh, I thought you got that. I thought you had that solved there, Fal.
I did.
With the power, with the power thing.
It wasn't the power, and I put my hand in by the chip, and it's not heat, so I don't know what did it.
The North Koreans. All right, Divehead. Be good, dude. Have a good good time shopping. Shopping for groceries. All right, so let's see. What's my inventory full of? Okay, I got a bunch of crap. Let's see, what do I? Oh yeah, good lord. You know, I've been harvesting stuff. I don't know what should I do with all the crap. I'm just throw it away. Don't really need to make anything. I just want to get the experience from the harvesting, and my workbench is kind of full.
Make some storage units.
Yeah, there should be plenty of storage units around. You could toss stuff in, Jill.
You know, I'm just gonna. It's wood and stone and nothing really valuable. I'm just gonna.
Diphid, you still here?
I think he's heading out. Oh, Murin disappears. Thanks for tuning in, Murin. We'll see you soon.
Oh, Gio, I found out what some of what was on sale from Warner Brothers Games, and I managed to get the Shadow of Mordor for $8.
$8 freaking bucks? Are you kidding?
Nope.
Oh, dude, that is a deal. Holy smokes.
Unfortunately, Shadow of War isn't on sale yet because it's not even on sale yet.
Item. Doo-doo-doo stone. Don't need that junk. Oh, do I have some glowy blue rocks, though? I do need those.
And the sale's still going on, by the way.
So, did my beast survive the weekend? Magic?
Yep.
They didn't eat each other?
No.
Miracles. Miracles. Now, is that blue stone thingy, is that something I need to put in the, was it light stone? Where should I store that?
Either the workbench or your magic bench.
You know, I need a, either we need a different location for the water spout. Can you just have it come right down the wall here?
No, move the magic workbench, that's much easier.
Really? Then,
yes.
Well, but there's no place to put it. It's in the only spot where it can go. No, it's the
only. I can move it. I'll move it.
No, but I want it right up here. So it's.
Well,
it's,
then you'll just have to deal with the water spout.
Oh. Maybe we could raise the roof.
Gio, how about taking out your walls and some ceilings for extended out and then put back?
Take out the ceiling?
No, take out the walls, extend your floor, which would be ceiling, out, and then
We could do that. There. Just push that back wall out and then move the workbench back. I can do that.
But then that'll mess up my cute little bridge here.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Okay, let me look at the water supply and see if I can move it. It's not that easy, but I can probably do it.
Oh, man, seriously, can I get back up? Oh, come on, there we go. All right. So, I got some hide and stuff. See, I got 3 spots left here. Nah. I need the twine to make arrows, correct?
I think so.
What am I doing on, I'm 180. Not, you know why I was so heavy before? I was carrying all these building supplies around. I mean, pieces that I already built. Stacks and stacks upon stacks. Crazy stacks of stuff. Okay, I got a lot of hide, but it doesn't weigh much. And, oh, you know what? I got 1,100 gold. I don't want that crap. Some goblin will come bite me in the butt and take it. Any chance we can start a little village out here and get some vendors?
Not like Conan. No thralls or vendors.
Oh, it's you. So what...
I know what I can do. Fal, you don't use your room here anymore, do you?
No.
I'll put the pipe through the wall and we can have the water and... Fal's old room here.
Kind of like a toilet.
A shower.
A shower. Okay. A bathroom. Yeah. All right. Nice. I like that. Do we have glass yet? Bad Viking. Yeah, the rain does sound real, doesn't it? All right. The sound of that running water drives me nuts. And it is loud. Oh, what a beautiful day. Except, what is up with that hornet's thing? That is terrifying, you know.
It's just bees. It makes honey.
It does?
Yeah. Look inside it.
Oh? Oh, I don't like being this close. It's almost as bad as spiders.
It won't hurt you.
Look at that. What the hell is that? Royal jelly. And honey. Oh, that's just crazy. So, what do you need to make royal jelly from honey? That's just wacky. So, what's the royal jelly used for?
Keeps your hive healthy.
Okay.
It's just another kind of pet. I'm not sure exactly. It may have a future use.
Oh, my dude has got rotten meat. Oh, he's going to get sick from it, won't he?
I don't think he'll get sick, but he'll probably be hungry.
Oh, my. Yeah, he's got to be starving. So, good thing the pets don't, do a runner when they just get a little tired of what you're not feeding them. Weight. Okay. Yeah, he's good so far on weight. We gotta feed this beast. Hey, welcome back.
Geo, I found out who said that learn more from failure than success.
Oh, who's that?
Samuel Smiles.
Samuel Smiles.
And it makes sense. He's a Scotsman.
Did they increase the volume of wings flapping?
I thought they were really loud yesterday.
Yeah, it's little tweaks. Okay. All right. Well, I need to go feed my beast.
Feed the beast.
He sure is a flappy fellow, ain't he? And huge thanks to Pantera.
Yep.
Oh, look. There's a hyena thingy.
Roar. Come here, you stupid dog.
He's killing the sheep. That was my sheep. Oi. Man, that guy's just clueless. He's busy eating the sheep. Take him. Yay! Oh, did I ding? I ding too. Wah, wah. There we go. And then I guess I can eat his sheep. Or chop down a tree. All right. Look at this beast, everybody. This thing is seriously cool and
really pretty. Nice markings.
Yeah. Has he been? Did we colorize him already?
I think Balin tried to make him white, and that just emphasized his natural markings.
Yeah, this is a cool beast. This is a Nidhogg. Nid. Hey, Keith! Hey, welcome back, man. Welcome back. Good to see you, brother. And we are all over Al Gore's amazing internet. We're streaming live to Twitter at My Morning Brew TV. We're also at our headquarters here at Twitch at The Morning Brew Show. And on YouTube and Mixer, we're at Gladiators Cafe. Kind of the parent channel. So, look at him wag his tail. Oh, that is cool. Oh, look at the centaurs. So, when you schwack a centaur, do you get bad faction with centaurs? I mean, is there faction in the game?
Not that way, as far as I know.
Look at that. That is awesome, man. It's just so cool. Viking says, yeah, Keith, man, love this beast. He is just rocking. A lot of fun, I gotta say. And surprisingly easy to tame, at least on our server. The hell is going on here? Oh, who's that? Oh, bear. Bear! Oh, two bears, three bears. Oh my God. Fal, is that you?
Yep.
Dude, you got a bunch of bears. See if I can grab one of them.
Oh, bear got me.
Oh no. I hope they don't schwack your critter.
Yeah. I think he's got enough strength to hold out until I get back.
What level is your beast?
108.
Into the ground like a dart. Oh, when I schwack a tree, do I get negative faction with the ints? I don't know. Oh, man. Oh, there are so many beers. Oh, they just killed your beast.
Oh, crap.
Oh my God, five!
And I didn't have him stoned.
Five bears? Aww. Foul? Oh, dude, that is awful. You want me to pick up your stuff and bring it back to you, or what?
Try to take care of the bears, because I'm on my way.
All right. Well, it's a horde of bears. There's five of them. The brother's bear. I gotta land my crazy turkey dude. Oh, here they come. Woohoo! Neener. Oh, maybe they'll all drown. Hover over the water, get them to chase me in the river. No. Your poor beast didn't stand a chance, dude. So Bad Viking says, I really hope they work on the character animations. The thing that Ark hasn't fixed their animations, and Exiles characters' animations are fantastic. Yeah, I do like the Exiles. But I can't make a goofy, silly, retarded-looking character in Exiles. Just saying. Oh, Fal, what are you doing? Oh, the bears. Okay. Hold on, I'm coming.
I'm in God mode, GM.
Okay. Well, then let me snag one of these guys. Oh, and a panther? I hope that wasn't your pet that I picked up. Look at that.
No, I didn't run. I came by foot.
Look at that. That is just... Oh, man, that is just awesome. Wow! Is that freaking cool or what? Ah!
Bear's dead.
Oh, and I need to land on the trail here. Come on. Ooh. All right. Gee, it's hot. You need to find a cool place. Yeah. Ooh, 27 degrees. I wish they'd do the thing in Fahrenheit, because Celsius just screws me up. Being American and all, you know. Are those... Do we have gold? Is gold a harvestable thing, or...
Not that I know of. Those over there are
copper. And Fal, you had not stoned your beast? Ugh.
Nope.
Oh, dude. Are there dual saddles for any of these things?
I don't know.
You know what?
Ark has them for some animals, but I don't think they've added them here.
Man. Let's go check this out. There's another bad bear. Here, bear. That dude is running. What are you afraid of? Big bad bear. Yeah. You're a tough guy when you're by yourself, aren't you? Mm-hmm. Oh, how about this is just freaking awesome. Level 16 bear. He shouldn't last too long. Oh, and there's some birds doing some air combat up there. Into the ground like a dart. Oh, that is cool. Lunch. Now I'm hungry. Oh, you know what I want for lunch? Tacos. We talked about tacos all weekend. I gotta get some. Anybody here play StarCraft 2? Boy, Jet watched the World Championships over the weekend. We watched some recorded stuff of the World Championships. Man, he is hooked. His dad, I want to do that. I want to do that. I think you can do a good job, Fal.
I do too.
Hey, Zang, I didn't see you sneak in, man. Welcome. Good morning. Your mic is muted. If you set... push to talk for this channel, you should be able to chat. But good to see you all the same. Let's talk about it. Yeah, B-Wolves, for sure, man. Bad Viking, dude. I love Blizzard games. Not a big WoW guy. I played WoW from day one. I played for like the first 6 months, and I was like, you know. This game, WoW is not my cup of tea. But StarCraft, Warcraft, the original Warcraft, Warcraft 2, Warcraft 3, love those. And man, enjoying the hell out of StarCraft.
OGO is a restaurant near where I live that makes beef brisket tacos.
Oh, those are the best, man. Beef brisket tacos. Well, Pantera likes the cow face tacos. They're yummy. Just the thought of it's gross for me.
I've had grilled halibut tacos.
Oh, God. That's my favorite of the fish tacos. Man, Alush. Thanks for the follow. Cheers. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to Twitch. Zang. Hey, no worries, man. No worries. All right. So you know what? My beast is a little injured. I keep hitting the wrong button. Got to hit R. Oh, no. He's all healed up. Okay. He's got an inventory full of stuff. He's got plenty of room left to carry crap. Whoa. Crap, that is the worst. Getting off my mount when I'm not ready. In the wrong place. Fal, do you need a lift anywhere, dude?
I'm headed to my place. In fact, why don't you come check it out, check out the new beast hole that's been...
Yeah, will do. Was that it right there?
No, that's Pantera's.
That's what I thought. All right.
Fal, you're being pretty brave.
I'm in God mode.
No, I mean inviting.
Remember?
Oh, yeah, inviting me over. Yeah, no, invite. She's talking about inviting me over.
That's what I said. I put in an anti-geo lock.
Oh, nice. Hey, what the hell? whoa, Pantera. What have you been up? What is this at Pantera's place? What is the purpose?
It's
the blue stuff.
It's framework.
Okay.
Framework lets you kind of plan out how you want to build, and then you replace it with other materials.
Fal, I think I can carry you. You want me to carry you?
We're almost there.
Oh, there it is. Oh, I didn't realize you were right down the road from Pantera's.
Yeah, he found this place was relatively nasty free and settled in.
Oh, check out, there's a griffin killing a kibu. Kibo.
That happens all the time. Sometimes there's like 8 kibos killing the griffin.
Wow. What is the material on this thing, dude?
Orvin Manor.
Oh, that looks cool.
That is, dude, that is amazing. Oh my gosh. Oh, look at that. The inner room and outer room. Oh, how come I can't fly backwards?
Not a hummingbird.
Is that a spider over there? No.
No spiders right now.
Dude, this is fantastic. So, how are you able to? You didn't craft this. Ballin crafted it for you?
No, everybody can craft it.
Really? Oh, so it's just something you got to learn, huh?
Actually, it's the easiest of the manners to learn.
Okay. Tig's wild thing. All right, Tig. Bobo Bebo, Biggin, Timorary. And who's this guy? You got a Vrock, right? Is that a wild Vrock? Or this is Vrock?
That's probably Halbjorn's Vrock. No, that's a wild Vrock. He flew in at one point and he got trapped.
And he's trapped. Okay.
He flew in while I was building the place.
Well, they're pretty nice creatures, all in all. The only thing they'll do is they'll eat one of yours if it dies, right?
Just I assume.
Meh. Man, look at you. Look at all that storage. God, look at the size of this place. Dude, we could make our own arena. That is astonishing. And these are, look at those foundational pieces. Those are huge.
Well, all of the manor pieces are 4 times the size of regular pieces.
So, all right. So where do I look up the skill progression? Go to knowledge?
Oi.
Hey, dude. Welcome back.
Uh-huh.
There we go.
It's, damn customers and work making me do my job.
I know. Isn't that pesky? But you got to love them. They're customers. Hey, Suna Lucas, man, welcome. Good to see you, man. Cheers. Welcome to the show. And Noisy, hello. Welcome on Twitter.
Pesky, annoying people ensuring that I have employment.
Yeah, I know. The nerve. So there's human manor, the dwarven manor. What? You got to get to player level 60 in order to unlock it, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
The dwarven's the easiest because all you have to do is harvest magic shards, and you do that quickly. The other two, you have to harvest mithril, and it goes really, really slow.
Because mithril is super rare.
No, you just need 40 million tons of it.
Yeah, I made a base up by the elves' floating towers by a mithril mountain. So if you ever want it, that's what I had to do. I just camped out there and mined mithril after mithril after mithril for hours.
Right. Whose house is that?
I know. This is Fowl's beast pen. He upgraded it. Double doors and
yeah,
and
I've got the stuff to do the fancy ironbound stuff now too. But that's really pretty.
Well, this is the dwarven manor.
These two are still fighting. I'm gonna shut the door on you, Fowl.
See, there's two Kibos now. There's a good chance the griffin's gonna die.
Now the Kibos won't kill you, right? They don't
aggro. Kibos are docile unless you attack them.
All right. Wow, look at that. Ringside seat to a battle. And the graphics. I love the graphics in this game. It's pretty good. Playing on max settings, epic, or whatever they call it. Options, graphics, epic settings, all the way. What the hell is the HDR thing? That's the hardware?
High dynamic range is what that stands for. It's the, it'll make darker things lighter and lighter things darker.
Okay.
It's dynamic, exposure? Yeah, dynamic exposure.
Okay.
It makes things look more natural.
Ew.
So the human eye perceives differences in exposure.
Right.
So we can see, things that are in dark shadow, even in bright light. But when you take a picture, the camera has to set the exposure to one thing. Mm-hmm. HDR was a technology that allows the camera to basically take multiple pictures at multiple exposures and mend them together so that it presents more like a human eye.
So that explains why I look good to myself when I'm taking the selfie, but when I actually look at the selfie, it's horrifying.
Right, exactly. The HDR would make you beautiful.
Got it. Thank you, Jonas, for unraveling that mystery for me.
It's like you look like, yourself, and then you use HDR, and all of a sudden you look like, I don't know. Who would you look like?
Tom Selleck.
Tom Selleck, yes, exactly. Jeez. I was going to say, like, Sean Connery, but...
Now, interesting.
Because you, like, the Scottish guy. Right.
Great.
Right. So, I don't know, sure that really would work on looks, though.
Right.
Hello, San Lucas. Welcome.
Yeah, San. Nice to have you, man.
Hey, yeah, we are really loving Dark and Light, for sure.
Yeah, big time. Big time. Oh, you play. Wow. So we're playing on Fallander's Dark and Light server. You can find it if you go to our Discord. You can see the link to our Discord is in our Twitch here. You can see the... we got the password posted somewhere. Where's the password posted? Game Talk?
I think so. Let me double check.
It's passworded because private is better.
Mm-hmm. Ahwa ula.
Mostly because those of us who play in as part of the Brew crew here, we're mostly Landmark players, and Landmark mm-hmm. was a cooperative building game, and yeah. so we like that aspect of Dark and Light. Yeah, unfortunately, there are a lot of griefers. So
it's in Game Talk, and it's a pinned message. So all you have to do is click the pin at the top when you're in Game Talk, and it'll show you the information.
So nothing happens when I fly through the magic portal here, but it sure looks cool. That is just... This beast, Pantera, thank you so much, dude. Wow. That beast is just fun to fly. Now, there was mithril up here, correct?
No, not here. The mithril's on the snow mountain.
Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, what, then what are these, iron? Iron ore deposits?
Iron. Iron and then the goldish colored ones are copper.
Okay.
So I got a lucky clover the other day, but I couldn't find a merchant that wanted to buy it.
Those are hard to get, dude. Wow.
I still have it. I don't know what it's for, though.
So, San Lucas, what level are you so far in Dark and Light? And what's your favorite server to play on? Now, will this thing harvest minerals?
No, you need a Kibo or a Bahamut.
All right.
Get my Bahamut.
Bahamut?
Bahamut.
And Bahamut.
You know, dogs from down in Southern California?
Oh, I hit him on the nose. Oh, God, he's going to kill me. Oh.
I mean, I know that it's actually a Bahamut, but it's a Bahamut. Dogs from Southern California.
All right, I got some iron.
Like Beverly Hills Chihuahuas, Jonas.
What was that?
Like Beverly Hills Chihuahuas.
Exactly, Bahamut.
All right. Well. So get one piece of mithril in there when I'm doing that. Cerula, hello. Hey, dude. Can you actually join us today? What are you playing? What are you doing? What kind of mischief are you getting into? Oh my God, I need to sleep or I'm gonna die.
Oh man, I took the wrong turn.
So this is cool. This thing, this beast can fly like nobody's business. It's like an F-16. It's awesome. I love it. So Jonas, I woke up this morning. It was 39 degrees.
I know, right? It was so cold this morning.
I mean, what the heck? Literally, what the heck?
It was like 90 yesterday. Exactly.
Yeah.
What the heck?
I mean, you know, a cool front had moved in yesterday, but still, we had temperatures in the high 70s, low 80s.
Yeah, it was like 88 or 84 or something like that yesterday.
Remember, pretty much for the entire East Coast, you could say if you don't like the weather, wait 5 minutes.
Dude, right?
Just craziness.
Yeah, I was talking to Tigris the past couple days, and yeah, it's freezing here too.
All right, Beast, stay
put.
I
might have a job interview in Chicago on Friday.
Chicago?
Yeah, they'll want me to move there. I'm not so sure about that.
No.
I went to boot camp in Great Lakes. I know what the weather's like there.
Oh my. Yeah, I wouldn't want to live in Chicago. I lived up there in that area for 5 years and swore I'd never go back.
Yeah, I mean, I worked, you know, for a couple of companies around there, and I would register Chicago drivers as the worst in the country.
Yeah, oh. I think Tidewater drivers are the worst in the country.
Yeah, DC is not so good either.
I got Chicago number one, Miami number two, number three, Massachusetts number four, New Jersey. I guess I haven't really spent a huge amount of time in DC though. I've driven around it a few times. I enjoyed driving around there.
The problem in DC is everybody is so nosy. I mean, crazy nosy. It's
DC also has the same problem Tidewater has. They have drivers from everywhere, so nobody drives the same.
So one of the things I noticed about Massachusetts drivers that's really annoying is that they don't understand the concept of space between bumpers.
Welcome to New England.
If you want to know where
that happens. You hit the Jersey line when you just... It's like that until you get to north of Vermont.
I suppose. But there's something about Massachusetts drivers specifically. Like, I can guarantee you 100% of the time, if there's somebody driving in my blind spot to my back left, they have a Massachusetts license plate. There's just something about them. They drive with their bumpers, like, right next to you. It's weird as hell.
Yep. Mm. Yep, it's they, and you'd think they'd be bigger fans of NASCAR. You know, I'm just saying. Oh, San Lucas, you're level 59. Oh, dude, playing on a friend's server. Nice, man. Not tried the official. The official's, I didn't like the official servers.
No, we tried the officials, and we'd get ganked when we were offline. People would rob our corpses. It was awful. It was just awful.
Oh, hey. Evertainy, man, if I want F16 speed, spam the control key? Really? Okay. All right, I have to try that. Oh, my God. San Lucas, it's snowing where you are? Where the hell are you? Like the Alps?
We posted it's snowing in Canada.
Oh, wow, dude. All right, I need, I need something to eat. Where do we store the snacks? I'm telling you, the first time I wound up... Do we have any beef?
I don't know if there's anything that would be...
Where's the beef? Well, here's the ice guy. Do we have a fridge in here? I thought we had a freezer.
Well, it's him, but...
Oh, really? Oh, really?
But you'll
it's
have
getting
to,
a little dark.
You'll have to cook something. Okay, just a sec.
What are these? Flip the clock forward like 10 hours.
Cured meat.
Can eat that.
Really? But there's a little spoiled meat icon. It says spoil into a cut of cooked meat that has been cured. Dried meats preserve much longer before spoiling. Wow. Seriously?
Yeah, that's why you use the meat racks.
Daggone, dude.
Because you can make these the cured meat will last for like weeks. Thank you.
That's like 10 pounds, 20. I got 20 pounds of beef.
I've got 50 pounds of cured beef in my meat racks right now.
Oh my gosh. Okay. I got to try that. Holy smokes. So how does it taste? Use item.
I usually use like 10 to 15 of them depending on how much hunger I have. I mean, I've got 150 hunger total. When I get down to about half, it'll take about 15 or 20 to get me back up to full.
Not too shabby, dude. All right. So handy if you're doing a lot of combat.
Cerulea, yeah, for sure.
So Cerulea, man, look at you. Cerulea is like the man with the plan. He's got all this cool stuff. And Cerulea's ride. Where's his ride?
Parks it elsewhere.
And he's not going to tell us or tell me.
Yes, he parks it not near you.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Smart.
So, Cerulea, what's up with Mischief having a date this weekend or next weekend? And who's Mischief?
San Lucas, you're in Calgary. Sweet Christmas, dude. Nice.
I hear it's beautiful. Right. Up there.
So Ever says spam the control. I was just holding down the shift key. Oh, look at that. There's the barrel rolls magic.
Aha. Uh-huh.
So shift and oh, look.
Oh, there you go. Cool.
Freaking crap. That
we
is
always
just...
do that, Viking. That's kind of part of it.
Yeah, that's why you watch.
Hijinks ensue.
Yeah. Zhang says, I thought that wasn't so unusual. It's a true story.
So control is barrel roll?
Yeah, control.
No barrel.
Look at that, man. Oh, yeah, dude, that is... Look how much faster you go when you do the barrel roll. Into the ground like a dart. Oh, and it uses up... Oh, that is just...
Yeah, I bet you it uses your stamina pretty heavy.
That is insane. Oh, my God. Dude, thank you. Oh, yeah, Ever, man, that is awesome. Thank you, thank you. Holy crap. I had no idea my beast could do that. He's got to land, though. Come on, come on. Come find some ground. There we go.
Lag.
Oh, look at the kitties playing over there. They're playing with a hog.
Yeah, just in case you ever need it, man, feel free to... You can go into my house in the kitchen. There's a meat rack in there that's always got hundreds of meat on it.
I will check it out. Oh, no, what's... Oh, man. Oh, hello. What level is that guy? Did I get him? Oh. Oh, no, I didn't. He is... That is one bad kitty, man. Oh. I keep right-clicking. I dropped the little dude. The hell. I feel like an ostrich. Oh, look at that. They found... Oh, man. There's some mayhem going on there. Man, that panther is... he is a badass. How can I... Oh, he's level 120. You know what? We'll just say goodbye to the panther. I'll go pick on someone not my own size. Dude, that is just wicked cool. Oh, magic. Do you have one of these, magic?
I actually did get one. Once Pantor showed us where and how, I got creative.
Will the other control make him go the other direction now? Wow, that is really cool. Acer Playboy, welcome, man. Welcome to the show. My upload speed is pretty epic. My upload's like 530 megabit. My building here, it's got gigabit Ethernet, but I'm connected wirelessly. So 530. Man, wow. That was so much fun. All right, let's tiptoe along the shore. Now, these guys can't go in the water, can they?
I think it dismounts you.
And then drowns the bird. But I hear these guys...
No, you just have to press F7 and whistle, and then they'll follow you out of the water.
No!
Watch this. Take down a whole tree with just one swing. I wish I could then take, you know, like have the tree, the fallen tree, stay in the game, and then you got to chop it up, or pick it up and drop it on bad guys. Just saying.
Definitely agree that there could be more to harvesting.
Yeah, but look, I think they're doing a great job with the game. I'm crazy about it. I'm hooked. Since we lost Landmark, nothing has filled that void. Not even close. We're hoping that Dual Universe might do that, but, you know, it's filled with the challenges of every other game that got their start via Kickstarter. Yeah, sad face. The loss of Landmark, man. That was a tough one. Oh my god, is there spiders in there? Look at this place.
Oh yeah, that's a really cool place except for all the spiders.
Oh, and they're eating. What the heck is that thing? Is that like a good god almighty? That's a giant mushroom eating crab? Oh, wait a minute. No, those are... Oh my god, what am I looking at down there? Ooh, I can't believe I'm going here by myself. I'm afraid to see what level these things are. Is that a fire? No, what kind of elemental? Is that a swamp elemental? Come on. Oh, those beasts are so cool. Well, they look kind of hot, but you know.
Wow, that's cool. Or hot.
Some kind of demon. That is just... Oh my god.
You want to tell San Lucas about the rise and fall of Landmark?
Oh wow. We started from the very beginning of the alpha test. Landmark was being developed along with EverQuest Next, and it was touted as the engine that was going to be used to make EverQuest Next. And what a vision. Landmark was a completely editable world.
Completely visionary.
You could create just magnificent things, all made out of voxels, so they could be warped and shaped, and all kinds of trickery could be done.
Yeah, they were definitely special voxels. We're not talking like Minecraft voxels, but the voxels in Landmark could be shaped and changed in shapes however you wanted them, so you could basically make anything with it.
It was extraordinary. If you go watch some of the video content over on the Landmark Explorer channel, which is my original channel. Oh! 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 That dude yanked me down to the ground. Holy crap! I want to find out what the hell level he is, but I can't. I put the cursor over him. Yeah, if you go to our Landmark Explorer channel, you can see we got 1,000 videos that we made from our streams. It was an amazing game. It was owned by Daybreak, and they sunsetted the game back in February.
Yep.
Oh no! Are these two dudes? Is it like BattleBots? Are they fighting each other? No. Oh my god, it's a Fire Lord! He's only level 8. Oh, dude, I'm taking ya.
I've noticed that levels almost make no difference at all in this game.
Really?
Like, a level 100 sheep has as many hit points as a level 5 sheep.
Man, I'm trying to pick this guy up. That's not working.
He's a bit too big.
Is there such a thing?
Yep.
Fire Lord. This is a cool area down here, man. Oh, his butt is mine. Look at this. I bite him, I don't get anything. Boy, he decomposed pretty fast, too.
Look in your inventory. Sometimes it doesn't show what you got.
Oh, that's true.
Press R and look in your bird's inventory.
Nope, nothing there. And I got nothing. Huh. Ooh, that was neat. Just probably a new beast. I don't know. That's the first time I've ever seen a Fire Lord. And apparently you can knock over these mushrooms.
They're not a new beast. They're mostly over on Fire Island.
Oh, okay. I'm so brave. He was level 8. Jeez. Yeah, it was Landmark was an amazing game. We're patiently and eagerly awaiting its next rival. It's made with the Voxel Farm engine, and so the new version of Voxel Farm, pretty amazing. A lot of people from Landmark have been helping out with the evolution of that engine lately. So where the hell am I going? I'm kind of doing the solo thing today.
I don't know. I found an island with a wrecked ship on it yesterday. It was filled with wraiths and skeletons. I did not land.
That would be cool. It's one of the things I like doing here. Is I like just having a peek at everything.
Yeah, that's what I was doing. I was just out exploring.
Who is that?
Hello there.
Zeno.
Hey, Zeno. What's happening, man? Squishy.
Not much. Figured I'd drop by.
Dude. Saturday was pretty cool.
It was.
It was too short. Too short.
It was. It definitely was.
Do you play any other games currently?
No, I bounce around way too much. Mostly yeah. Just Planet Coaster and Space Engineers.
Voila deleted her Twitter channel. Have you guys heard from her at all?
Nope, I haven't heard a thing.
I wonder what the hell she's up to. She was amazing. San Lucas, dude, yeah, they scrapped the whole thing. Yep. After pouring a gazillion dollars into it. They got, Daybreak got, actually, it used to be Sony Online Entertainment, and they got acquired by Daybreak. Really acquired by a venture capital firm. We've been telling San Lucas here in the stream about Landmark.
Oh, nice.
So there's more Nidhoggs up there. Now these things, they'll attack me, won't they? Hey, Bask, thanks for the follow, man. Cheers, yes. Welcome to the show.
Yes, they will.
I wish there was a way to tell what the hell level they are without getting up close. Dude, this is so cool. That whole barrel roll thing. So it's a little colder over here, isn't it? Anybody know when we're getting the content upgrades? Do we have an ETA on those? You know those big areas that have the blue perimeter fence around them in dark and light?
I haven't seen anything. Found that waterfall yesterday. Isn't that gorgeous?
That's stunning.
But no, I haven't seen any updates on the blue circle-y things.
Now, it looks like some kind of foundation here. What the heck is this?
I think it's a soul node. I went and checked it out.
Wow.
I was kind of thinking that'd be a cool place to build.
This is exactly what I was thinking.
Okay, although I haven't seen any yet, it seems that Dark and Light has one of the most hated creatures from our...
The poo monster?
No. Piranha.
Oh, no. No, no, no. They're not introducing the piranha, are they?
Well, they've got a spawn code for it.
There's muck rippers. There's bad, nasty fish in the water.
Yeah, yeah. Not a place to go swimming.
But I've run into muck rippers, and they're not near as bad as Ark's piranha.
Yeah, the piranhas...
That could well be.
Piranhas are freaking brutal. Hey, Squish, do you play mini Blizzard games?
Oh, a handful.
What's your favorite?
Right now, I'm torn between Heroes and Overwatch.
Me too. I just added StarCraft 2 to that mix. I'd never played StarCraft 2 before. Love the original game. Man, my son and I are hooked. Absolutely hooked.
I was very annoyed by StarCraft 2 and never purchased any of the expansion packs because I don't play multiplayer. So I was very disappointed at spending $80 for about 15, maybe 12 hours of entertainment. Because that's how long it took me to get through the campaign. And then they wanted me to give them like another $40 for a second campaign. I was like, yeah, screw you guys.
Yeah. Coon, thanks for the follow, man. And San Lucas, dude, thanks for the follow. Welcome to the Morning Brew Crew, buddy. Glad to have you. Great Scott. Now, I have no idea where I'm on the backside of all this. Oh, look at that. When you're gliding, you're right. The beast wags his tail.
That's really funny, Cerula. Cerula's going to be playing as Geo in a D&D game.
Dude, that's awesome. You got to record it. I mean, you guys got to stream your D&D game. Ooh, is that a Yeti? What the hell is that thing? Oh, and look at all the fish. Oh, they're all coming to eat that thing. Oh, that is just crazy.
Oh, look at that. They're just like swarming.
Oh, that is terrifying. What the hell? What kind of beast is that? It's an earth elemental.
They shouldn't be able to bite him. He's rock.
Yeah. Oh, they just killed him. He's dead. And look, every time they bite, there's like, these are electric fish. That is just...
Oh, yeah, sparks. Wow.
That is really frightening. You see how far away they were coming from?
Yeah.
Oh, that is freaking dreadful. Don't go in the water. And they're eating the dude.
Well, I guess I won't be building a swimming pool over there.
Oh, what the heck? I'm standing on my mount. Oh, please, God, let me get back on him. Woo! All right. Interesting. I was going to try and take a bite of the guy, but it dismounted me. That could end poorly here.
Yes, that would end poorly. You did stone your mount, but you didn't stone Geo.
Look at that. That is something. The game is just beautiful.
Yeah, that water is gorgeous.
Oh, hey, check it out. There's a little building over here. Little destroyed village. Now, if my beast gets killed and we use the res stone to bring him back, does he come back at the level he was when he was stoned or at whatever his...
Yeah.
Oh, really? So you gotta restone them regularly.
You can't restone them. Well, you could. If he died and you rezzed him and he came back at the level he was, you'd have to level him up and then restone him. Okay.
Oh, ever, man. Thanks, dude. It says once an elemental creature is dead, you can harvest it with your staff or pickaxe. Get the cores. Can you attack with a staff while you're on your mount? No. Nope. Not a thing. Look at this tree. Oh, this is... Oh, more mushroom stuff. Oh, and giant spiders. Oh. Ah. Crap. Oh, my God. Now, oh, what the hell is that? Is that a giant bat? It is! Did I just fly in a great big circle? I don't know. And this is just another swamp area. Now, can you harvest these mushrooms like trees? And if so, what do you collect from them? Because I ain't getting off my ride. Ain't no way. Oh my God, look at that! Oh, don't. Jeez, O-Peasy. Look at all the beasts. It's not safe here. Fal, what the hell did you do to the server, man?
Not me, but I can fix it if you've got an overspawn.
It's just, I saw that wyvern go down to the ground, and then all of a sudden, out from every nook and cranny came wolves and a panther. Oh, the panther was the sole survivor. Those panthers are righteous, aren't they? All right, there's the Matterhorn. That's by the Elvenland. I did a circle. All right, I'm gonna head over here. Oh, good Lord! What the hell did I do? I hit E. Am I not on my mount right now? I think I need to change that hotkey from E to something else, away from my WASD keys. Just saying. Dude, that, ever, man, thanks for this tip. That is so cool. Now, you can attack with an iron spear while you're mounted on a horse, but probably not on these beasts. Oh, there's that ridge, the mountaintop there. I was there earlier. That's where that magic portal is. And magic, the waterfalls here are really something.
Yeah, I just love that. Oh my gosh, there's another one. Yep.
So jealous of you guys with your flying mounts. At some point, I'll have to figure out how to do that.
There's extras over here at the guild hall. Want a party.
Yeah, I know. You guys have one, but I don't want to, like, you know, use your things and screw something.
You sound like me.
Yeah, the difference is that I actually, like, don't screw it up, though.
I heard that.
All the ones that I own over here, Jonas, I've stoned. So if you want to borrow one and it dies, I can revive it. No worries.
That's all right. I think it would be more fun at some point for me to just figure out how to tame things and do that.
Okay. Can you reuse the stones?
No, you have to make a new one.
Okay. Ooh, now I'm getting cold.
I'm working now on the second level of my tower.
Thank you. that bear, man, eating caribou. It's what's for dinner. All right. Rest up. Good grief, man. This is just crazy. What the hell is this dark tower thing?
Oh man, I had a day at the dark tower.
Oh really?
I died 8 times.
Oh now, good, now I know where you are.
Now did you wear your fur armor that everyone's been making?
Yeah, I was wearing fur armor. I was just having a bad day.
Bargash attacked me, I one-hit it.
Oh man. Rune of Restoration.
Geo, where you are at the at the Snow Mountain with the Dark Tower, there is Mithril there.
Okay. Wow, so I'm taking damage from the cold?
Yeah, probably. That's what killed me, so you either want to put on fur stuff or get out of there.
What the hell is that thing?
Brimstone.
What is that? The white thing hugging the tree?
A yeti, maybe? No, that's ice elemental.
No, that is not an elemental, dude.
Yes, that's an elemental, not an imp. You're thinking of imps. That's an elemental.
Is that an ice lord? Oh, what?
It has another name to it, demon something, I think. But it's an ice elemental.
Okay, it says ice elemental. Oh, I'm still taking damage. God, lord. -7 Celsius.
That's what killed me. You're gonna die. Do you have any brimstone to put on?
Geo having gear? Like, to handle contingencies? Come on.
Yeah, I do. I do have brimstone, but I left it back at the house.
Get somewhere warmer fast.
So you
fast.
Have it, but...
Because if you die, you're gonna lose your mount, probably.
All right.
Dang it. I do that constantly. I build items in the workbench and then run away to go and place them without putting them in my inventory.
That's what I do all the time.
I do it both here and in Ark.
They really just need to make that so that when it's done crafting, if you're close, it just goes into your inventory.
Oh, come on. It is still cold? Are you kidding me?
Get somewhere warmer.
I'm trying. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Go to Minor Pantera's place and go inside, Geo.
My God. I'm just trying to get somewhere safe. Good thing this beast is fast. Look at this sucker go, man. There we go. 5 degrees, 6 degrees, 7 degrees, 8 degrees. Boy, you have to really get down here to get to the warm area. There, back at the house. Well, wasn't that fun?
Adventures, yeah, you make the game so exciting.
Really?
Jeez. I didn't do anything. It's a miracle I'm alive. Now, so I put this stuff on my hotbar, but I was like unable to use it. Rune of Restoration. Do I have to get off my mount to do that? Probably. Yep. Can't do it while mounted. That's too bad.
There you go. Now you're
insert vaguely sexual innuendo here.
Jeez. Anything below 0 Celsius, you'll take damage from. Yeah. Man. Okay, so let me go get the warm stuff. So Fal made me some. Wasn't it Fal or was it Cerulean? Someone made me Long John's.
Thank I you. Made you some brimstone.
Yeah, Fal gave you brimstone.
Ooh. Ha. Ha ha. I just gotta find it. Oh, I left my door open. All right, there's... Oh, there we go. Oh, Legendary Brimstone Tunic. I suppose I should just put all the stuff in my inventory.
Be done yep. with it.
Anything heavy I need to dump? A stone. Nope. Why do I waste so damn much, though? Holy cow. Oh, it's all these troughs. All right, I gotta... But I need those. Okay, it's good.
What, troughs? Only carry one or two.
Boy, that meat doesn't do much.
Yeah, like I said, I usually eat them in batches of 5, 10, or 15 at a time.
It's like some beef jerky. Ugh. Dude, I gotta end the show early. I need to get tacos. If I don't have tacos, I'm going to go mad.
You're already mad. You can't.
So, being outside the nation's capital here in the U.S., Washington D.C., we have extreme immigration happening here, and the upside there is we have every kind of restaurant imaginable. And lots of them. So, yeah. Whether you like Asian, Middle Eastern, Mexican. And it's not just you know, Mexican food. I mean, really specifically, there's Guatemalan, Salvadorian. It's just the chicken places here. I'm going crazy.
Oh, you're making me hungry.
I know.
Yeah, seriously, knock it off, man.
It's the only place that has better Tex-Mex than we have is like San Antonio. Just saying. And the stuff in San Antonio is like half the price it is here. All right, so I got 10 minutes. How far can I go in 10 minutes and make it back? Oh, and just curious, how far up? I mean, we have a ceiling, right? Oh, is there... Can you make a mac? You can make macros in the game? Damn, for healing amounts. That's what I need. Freaking macro.
Geo, you even have a restaurant in D.C. that's almost impossible to find in America.
Oh, what's that?
One that serves rice stuff.
Wow. Oh...
Which is a Norwegian Indonesian
food. Oh my god. I'm gonna fly to the damn moon! Oh, there's the ceiling! Ah!
Yep.
Oh, I'm above the ceiling. Look at that. Look. Fly me to the moon. Ooh, it's cold up here.
Oh, that's cool. Oh no, he's gonna die again.
Yeah.
It's gonna be stuck.
Put on some brimstone. Oh, that will stink. I have to use a parachute to get down. I'll have to do all future shows from here.
What the heck is going on?
Oop. Fly me to the moon. Let me dance among the stars. Look at that. Oh my god, that is awesome. I'm above the world, baby. Look at that. Space. These are the voyages of Geo and his Nidhogg. Oh, I'm making noises. You hear that? Oh. What is going on? Oh, man, I'm still losing hit points. Geo in space. All right, let's see if I can break through the atmosphere. No. Come on, man.
Geo, if you break through the atmosphere, you die.
Really?
Already done it when I wasn't in God mode. Yep.
Oh, instant. Okay.
And you lose everything.
Oh, come on. I got all my brimstone armor on and I'm still taking damage. I mean, like, quickly.
Well, because you were going through the ceiling.
Oh, man.
And this show is brought to you by What Not to Do in Dark and Light.
Right? Do not attempt to fly through the ceiling of the universe. You will lose your mount there.
Oh, boy. Look at this. Oh, now it's 21 Celsius? Okay. If you get too hot, you take damage. It's like the no-win scenario, man.
Yeah, but 21 is fine.
All right, so...
I think.
All right, so my beast is hovering. All right, I'm going to stand up. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy, I'm on a wing. Try to heal myself. Come on, let me back on. Yay! Oh, that worked! Cool. How about that, huh? The flying will end them, brothers. There we are. Oh, Christ. I need a taco. Get me out of here. Damn, this is... Dude, Ever, you made my day, man. Thank you. I am just... Wow, totally jazzed.
I'm glad it's almost showing because my migraine's breaking back through.
Yeah, boy. All right. So, Magic, you know, we need a landing strip, guys. Can we make a runway? We really do need a runway.
You just land in the middle and then walk up the ramp. And that was intended to be a runway before everyone got such huge creatures.
Yeah. If you're flying a hornet, literally a hornet, can we fly those things?
No, but if Balin or Ing came over to our place and stood by the bee's nest, they'd come up, they would materialize and come out and attack them.
Yeah, that's what happened. Balin came over to color my mount. He was naked in just a couple of minutes. It was dreadful. Man, and I'm dying from thirst. Oh my God. It's not one thing, it's another. My health is still going down. Oh, now I'm too hot. Oh my God. This game. Too much survival.
Much survival in the survival game.
Yeah, it's I don't know. Wait a minute. Where's legendary? So I got regular shoes. Oh, where's my trousers? Oh my God, finally. I'm like almost dead. Look at this. It's just ridiculous. Jeez. How can you do anything when you gotta be... Ugh. So, I don't know. we need to stone my big bird because he's gained a whole bunch of levels. And at my rate, it's not going to go well.
He's already stoned though.
Yeah, but at like 10 levels ago.
Yeah, but you can't restone it.
You can't restone it? Aw.
Once it's stoned,
hey, Shark.
You can't restone it until that dies.
Shark, man, welcome to the show, buddy. Okay, wow.
That's why you put your used stones in someplace safe.
Yeah, I have. They better be still be here. I'll be so pissed if I lost it. Come on, where is it? There it is. There's my stone. Summoning stone. Well, that was fun, guys. Wow. All right. Well, I didn't really get anything done today. Hey, Shark. Thanks, man. And likewise, great name for you too, brother. Wow. So, Jonas. Oh, you know what? Jonas, I got an instrument just for you. I'll play it tomorrow if I can find it. I was talking to Jed about it. We were reading some Mark Twain and of course they were talking about what instrument to play to, you know, they're breaking Jim out of jail. Anybody read The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn?
Long time ago.
Oh, years ago.
And Mark Twain, that guy had an imagination. Oh, my God. Someone funny, dude. Everybody, thank you for watching the Morning Brew Show. We're going to break until tomorrow. I'm going to go get some lunch. It's taco time. Oh, my God, tacos. Fal, I wish you were here, dude. I'd take you out to lunch. Everybody, be good. Go out there and build something.
You didn't miss it.
Yeah. Are we there yet? Oh, my God. And I'm hungry again. I got to eat. What the hell is going on? It'd help if I use the right mouse button.
Dragon slaying is makes man hungry.
Well, death-defying feats from 20,000 feet. Man, be good, well, everybody.
Jill, if I ever do make it up there, we'll have to go to Alexandria for the Indonesian rice battle.
Oh, yeah, I know exactly where that place is. I know exactly where you're talking about. Man, Alexandria's got great food. Oh, this whole Northern Virginia area is just filled with cool restaurants. All right, guys, we'll see ya. Have a great day. Thanks for watching the Morning Brew Show.
Bye, Jill. Thank you.
Later.
The Morning Brew Show is a production of Gladiators Cafe. Our senior producer is Falandir. Our senior moderator is Magic. And thanks to everybody, Jonas, Difid, Fal, for putting stuff in our newsfeed. Make sure you're following us on social media. On Twitter, you can catch us live at My Morning Brew TV. And my personal channel, which we did Landmark on, is Landmark Explorer and, of course, Gladiators Cafe. You can follow Difid at Hammerman1993 and Falandir at Falandir _ and Pantera at Pantera _Guck. Thanks to I'm a Winner Chicken Dinner for the 3D graphics and Tinma for our Morning Brew Show logo. Love you guys. Be good. Be safe out there. Go build something. And thanks to everybody on the Brew Crew. Love you guys. For all your support over the years. We'll see ya. See you tomorrow. You don't dare to reach. I could be brave. Could stop to breathe. That I might taste the sweetest cake. But I spin and spin. Round in the devil's grin. For you. I